So I wanted to come on YouTube. Hi, everybody. This is Divine 219 Lady, and I had an epiphany. Not too long ago, I was about to take a nap, and I'm like, "Wait a minute, that's it." And it's amazing how God give you the answers you need out of for the Bible scriptures at a later date. It could be the same day, that moment, but I have been dwelling on what is the falling away, and we don't know exactly what the falling away is. A lot of people assume that it's the church, which makes a lot of sense. It does add up to be that, but it could be a lot of things that is defined as the falling away that's mentioned in Revelations before the Antichrist is revealed, the mark of the beast, the tribulation, so on and so forth. And as I'm laying down, I'm like, oh, I get it. And it's because something happened to me last week with one of my children. Now, I'm a mother of four. All of my children are adults. My oldest is 27, my youngest is 19. I recently moved to Florida, not even a year. It'll be a year in the middle of next month that I'll be a new resident of Florida. However, my youngest had the option to move with me. He opted out. He didn't want to leave his friends. He had his own money. He wanted to move in somewhere else in Michigan and stay there. So he decided to go ahead and stay there. But I noticed that since he hasn't been around me, that he's been kind of living his life in the world. Now, they were brought up in the Bible. They know scriptures. They know a lot of things, but at the same time, they're young and they took in what they wanted to take in, but to be, let's see, just to be safe, I'm gonna say they are grounded in scripture. So what happened was, he talks to me and he says some things that is really deep. But he mentioned to me that, when I left, he said, "It seems like you left and went away. And it seems like hell started afterwards." He kept associating the difference between heaven and hell. He's like, it's like you left and went to heaven, and we still here in hell here in Michigan. That was his correlation in 19. And I said, I don't know why you feel like that. He said, I don't know, but I feel like I'm living a game, like I'm in a matrix or something. I feel like you left us here and we're left to fend for ourselves, and you went off and all the peace left. So, we talked about it, but then it wasn't until last week that struck my attention over the weekend, and I said, I gotta post this on YouTube. Now, not too long ago, a week ago, he was complaining about his brothers. I guess he had some type of disagreement with them, and he was telling it to me, and he says, "You're not here anymore, so I can do what I want to do." And I said, "Well, what does that mean?" He said, "It's what I said. When you were here, it was holding me back from a lot of stuff that I really wanted to do, but you being here kind of stopped me from doing it. But now that you're gone, I have nothing to hold me back anymore, and I can do whatever I want to do that I want to do, within this world, within my limitations. I can do it now because you're no longer here." So I took that in and I said, "Well, why would you do that? You know right from wrong." He said, "It doesn't matter anymore. You're not here anymore, so it doesn't matter." So over the weekend, I dwelt on it. I cried over it. Talked to my other sons about it. And then yesterday, or the day before yesterday, could have been Saturday or Sunday, I came up with this epiphany. I said, "Wow, Lord. That's what it is, the falling away. That's what it is." My son, without knowing, he's associating what's going to happen with the falling away, the rapture of the church. And he said all this in the weeks to come up until this last point that gave me the notion to know the Spirit said the falling away is the church. Now, my son said it feels like I left is it was hell, basically hell on earth. He said like it seemed like the peace was taken out of the world because I came here to Florida and they were there in Michigan. Then he also said he has no reason to hold back anymore because I'm not there. I'm symbolizing myself as the church, the one who was teaching him right from wrong. No, don't do this. No, don't do that. And he says, but you're not here anymore. So there's no reason for me to even hold on to any of those standards anymore because you're not here, so I can do what I want to do. So the falling away of the church leads to destruction, the revealing of the Antichrist, because he's going to be doing things that the Antichrist would be doing, nothing that Christ would tell you to do. He's going to be doing everything opposite of Christ. If you're going to go ahead and join in on the festivities of this world or your feelings that's negative, you're going to be joining in with the Antichrist. I hate to say it, but just look at it for what it is. The falling away. You're falling away because I'm no longer there. So you have no reason to hold tight to none of the scriptures, none of the good anymore because I'm not here to bat it out with you. To say, no, that's not right. You don't want to do this. God don't want to see this. You don't have nothing to say no to you anymore so you can live how you want to live. The only thing that's going to change him is the power of God because I'm no longer there. So he's going to have to find strength within himself to overcome the adversities that he's about to face. And if you think about it, that was the epiphany shown to me right in my face. God was showing me the whole time how the end is going to be, how the rapture is going to take place, what's going to be the falling away. And that's the answer. I found out the answer to the falling away. And a lot of people say, oh, well, no brainer, duh, we know that already. But I needed to know that, okay? Even though I had a notion in my heart and in my mind, but me having that revealed to me through the Spirit makes it all the better. So if you have any questions, concerns, if you want to comment, please do. I don't like the fact that YouTube gives you an option to either make the videos for the children, but if you do, they can't, no one can comment on it. But if you make it for not for the children, then it's for people 18 above, then you can comment on it. That's just crazy. But oh well, that's the way the system works. You know, by the way, Facebook, Instagram, WhatsApp is out. I couldn't upload this stuff to Facebook. Satan is working, everybody. Satan is working. Stay grounded. Do not fall susceptible to the deception that's out here. Do not do it because, to be honest, it's not worth it. Please go and look at my videos. I've been posting. I'm back on here. A lot of people were faithfully on my channel. I fell away for a few years. I would dabble here and there, posting this and that. Then I got into my locks and I started doing lock videos. But, you know, that wasn't a channel for that. So I made those videos private. Everything that's on my page is just dreams, visions, and revelations now. Whatever I'm being revealed, I present those. Please share my videos, please, because they are Holy Spirit driven. I'm asking everybody to share my videos, like and subscribe, I'm sorry, on my page. And I'll do the same, especially if you're someone that's into end time prophecies as I am. And let me know what you think about this video, about my son, about the falling away of the church, the rapture, the end times, the tribulations. Let me know what you think. I'm so curious to know. All right, I'm out of here. This is Divine 219 Lady. Bye.